Well, what do you want?
What's this thing? New plot to frame Judy. Well, I've saved you the job. I've been to see Mrs. Davidson. I told her a few things about her.
Blubbermouth Latham strikes again.
You ought to thank me. At least I got her out of your hair.
Well, you better hope she gets a long stretch in the pound. Because she's not going to be too pleased with you, what with lagging on her and messing with her girlfriend. You and me better stay friends, just in case you need a little help.
I don't need you.
Then I'd build up those muscles if I were you. Help Pat fetch the stuff from the kitchen.
I see you for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
I've just spoken to Carolyn Simpson. Mm. She refuses to accept bail unless she knows where the money's coming from.
Stupid bride. Can't you see what it's doing to a mother?
Well,
I'll have a word with her, see what I can do.
You sure?
Yeah, of course I'm sure.
Jim, be careful, huh?
Mr. Fletcher, can you let us through to the laundry?
Oh, yes, I suppose so. There you go.
Ta. They're an awful mucky lot in that kitchen. I've never seen so much dirty washing.
Well, it'll give you something to do then, won't it?
Mr. Fletcher!
What's the matter, Chrissy? You think I'd be in solitary by now?
Why should I think that?
I've just had a little talk to the governor. Now, I've admitted bringing those drugs in. After all, that's why I'm here. But then she asked me something about an elephant. Now, I told her I didn't know anything about it. And it would just be my word against yours. Isn't that right, Chrissy?
If you lay a finger on me, Bea'll have you. Any bashing done around here, she does it.
If I wanted to bash you, sweetheart, Bea wouldn't stop me.
Well, if you knew about them drugs, how come you didn't warn Sharon? How come you let her take the rap?
Got her away from you, didn't it? I've been after Sharon to stop peddling drugs for years. Maybe a stretch in solitary will teach her a lesson.
We want to know something.
Fire away.
Did you set up Sharon like Judy said?
You calling me a lagger?
Could be.
Now, why would I want to do that?
You crack down on dope harder than the screws. Some of the women like a little something every now and then. Relieves the boredom. Sharon could have got it for us.
Over my dead body.
You're giving us the choice.
The only choice you've got is whether you're on my side or against me. Take Chrissy, for instance. She knows which side her bread's buttered on.
You can't have it your own way all the time, Bea. I've just had a very friendly chat with Judy.
What are you lot doing? Get back to work.
Be nice knowing you, Bea.
Mum!
Carolyn, I just want to get some sleep.
You've got to do something instead of just moping around.
We don't have to be in here.
We've been through all that.
Simpson, outside.
Why?
Because I told you to. I understand you refused an offer of bail.
What's it to you?
Why did you refuse?
Our family is not in the habit of accepting charity from strangers.
Oh, stop being so bloody priggish. Can't you see what it's doing to your mother?
Why are you so interested? You put up the money, didn't you?
All you need is somebody who's willing to be nominated. I can't, because of my job.
Look, can't you just leave me alone?
Accept the offer and you won't have to see me every day.
I won't be obligated to you.
For God's sake, there's no obligation. You've got to accept it because of your mother.
All right. For my mother, but not for me. Just get off my back.
I'll need that name and address.
I'll give you my aunt's address in Geelong and my uncle's in Albury.
Lizzie, have you seen my handbag?
In the bedroom where you left it.
What would you like for an engagement, Prezzy Dore?
Oh, I don't know, anything you can afford. Whereabouts in the bedroom?
In the wardrobe. I'll be able to afford anything I like when I get my compo. I'll be almost a millionaire.
I found it. You got to get that money yet. It'll be just like my mum's will. They'll keep you waiting as long as they can. I better go. I'll be late.
Where you off to?
I'm going shopping with Kevin's mum for my trousseau.
Gee, I love a shopping spree. I wish I could come too.
Oh, well, you're welcome. She's a real pain in the neck. Bloody stuck-up bitch.
I thought you got on all right last night.
Oh, I suppose so. But she's always on about how much she's got and how successful Kevin's going to be, and it's just like I'm nothing.
Look, you got your mum's house and you're going to have some money. You're as good as she is any day, love.
Yeah, I don't feel it sometimes.
Oh, go on. You'll get on all right, you see.
Yeah. Till she finds out I've got a prison record, then it'll really hit the fan. Oh, well, see you later.
Bye, Dore. Don't spend too much money.
Haven't got much to spend.
Hi, g'day.
You're pushing your luck leaving the laundry. The lunch bill hasn't gone yet.
Yeah, well, I thought it was a bit healthier to get out of the laundry for a while, so I told Vera that I had an attack of the trots.
Why?
Margot and some of her mates getting a bit stroppy.
Oh, no.
Nothing I can't handle.
Oh, well, take it easy, Bea. Mm-hmm. You can't do much if you get stuck back in isolation again.
Yeah, well, a good bashing is all some people understand. Listen, keep your ear to the ground for me, will you? I want to know who I can rely on if it comes to the crunch.
Oh, there's plenty still want you in charge. But Judy's just had all the luck so far, and she's so cool and collected about it.
Come on, O'Connell, get moving. Bea, why aren't you in the laundry?
Lunch, Mrs. Jackson.
Come in.
Simpson and Williams to see you.
Oh, good. Thank you, Mrs. Jackson. Oh, sit down, ladies, please. Well, I'm afraid I've struck a bit of a problem with your bail. I've been in touch with your brother and sister, Mrs. Williams, and they have refused to stand surety.
Wonderful. Lovely, close-knit family.
Oh, Carolyn, darling, be fair. They do have their own families to consider, you know.
Well, your family too, Mum.
Well, it's not the end of the world. There are other alternatives. Mrs. Williams, do you have anywhere you could stay if and when you're released from here?
Oh, only back home.
Oh, no, Carolyn. No, I couldn't, darling. The neighbours...
Well, it's either that or stay here.
Can't you come with me?
It's possible. The offer is still open.
I only agreed for your sake. You shouldn't be in here. You're sick.
I need you.
You can manage. Once you get out of here and back into familiar surroundings.
All right. Here's what we'll do. I will have you signed over to me. That way I can keep an eye on you and make sure you don't skip the country, right?
Thanks, Mr. Reed. She'll do it.
You're very kind.
Oh, don't mention it. It's all part of my job. Meantime, I'll get in touch with the police, let them know what's happened, and I'm sure we'll have a release order for you this afternoon. And then it will be my pleasure to drive you home.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Reed.
Mm. You want a sandwich, ma'am?
No, thank you, Kevin. Are you sure they don't mind you taking time off to drive us into town?
No worries. Extended lunch hour. If the bosses can do it, why can't the workers?
You'll be a boss yourself one day. I doubt if you'll feel that way then.
Oh, what's it matter as long as the work gets done? Oh, that'll be Dore.
Not before time.
Oh, g'day, Lo. Gee, you look terrific.
Oh, thanks, Kevin. Good afternoon, Mrs. Burns. Hello, dear. Ready for our little outing? Yeah, yes. I'll just freshen up and then we'll be off. Kevin, I don't think I can keep this up.
Why? You're doing fine. She really likes you.
Yeah, but have you told her about me?
No, not yet.
Yeah, well, she'll change her mind when you do.
Rubbish. Look, you thought the same about me at first, remember? No, just give her time. She'll be sweet.
I hope you're right. Our little lovebirds having a peck, are they?
Mum.
Well, we better be off, eh?
Yeah, all right. Mrs. Burns, Miss Anderson, your transport is waiting.
Thank you.